I chose you because you said you were weak. I chose you because I said, eeny, meeny, miny, mo. Remember how it went? Catch talking about it? If he hollers, I could change. I could make a whole Christian song out of it, you know. If he sins, I won't let go. Eeny, meeny, miny, mo. I could do all this stuff. This is what I do. And remember how we'd say, my mama told me to pick the very best one. And I know this is so simple and so silly, but sometimes it's the shallow stuff that sticks with us. It was like, how did he pick Peter? And I heard, my father told me to pick the very worst one, the weakest one, the most impulsive one. And he got in that boat. And that gave me hope. Because I make dumb decisions. So it's not my decision and my good decisions that I'm putting my faith in. Not as a pastor, not as a parent, not as a husband, not as a man. His decision. Give that one good push. All you're allowed to do is push it as hard as you can with one push. Don't keep your hands on it. 3, 2, 1. Who's the strongest person in the room? Who's the strongest person in the room? I mean the strongest person in the room. I mean the strongest person in the room. I mean, who's the strongest person in the chat? Somebody give me a flex emoji in the chat. Come on. Who's the strongest person? I need the strongest person in the room. I'm going to have to select somebody if somebody doesn't volunteer. In fact, give me three strong people. Notice I didn't just say men. I am very, very politically correct, y'all. I don't want to offend anybody. Who's the strongest? Give me the three strongest people. You're coming. They're all pointing at you. You, they're all coming. I know you got flowers on your shirt, but they said you're strong. Come on, man. Let's go. Let's go. I need one more. Bernie, are you coming? Who else is coming? Strongest guy in the room. Yeah, he is. He is. Come on. Come on. All three of you. Come on up. Come on up. Come on up. And I wanted to remind you of this. Y'all start clapping because this is about to hit you. This is about to hit you. Line up. Line up. Line up. Line up. Line up. Line up. When I say three, all on one side, I want you to push it as hard as you can with one push. You don't get to lock out. You don't get to do anything. But I just want them to realize you can be there for a backup in case we do it. But I heard the scripture say at the water's edge was a boat. And I was thinking about all my dumb decisions and how prophecy and the word of God over your life doesn't originate with the will of man. And I was thinking about the momentum of the decision. So what I thought about is how far it goes depends upon how strong you are when you start it. So on three, 1, 2, 3, push it. Look at that. Catch it. Oh, look at that. And it's all right because I wanted it to fall. And it's all right because I planned for it to crash. And it's all right because I set it up for the illustration. And I knew it would fall when I called them. And I knew it would break when I chose it. And I knew what was in it when they pushed it. So the question is, who started this? Who brought you into the earth? Who chose who? I don't think you chose Jesus. I think he got in your boat a long time ago. If I'm the one pushing it, no offense. If it's Peter's decision, if it's Peter's prophecy, if it's human will, it stops when I sin. But if you understand that no prophecy, no word God spoke over your life, no assignment he gave you, nothing he put you to do started with you, I hear the Lord saying, the momentum is not based in your decision. It's based in his.